unprecedented move, the secretive community of Gloriavale has opened its doors to an independent inquiry. One News can reveal that two Christchurch lawyers have been granted unrestricted access to the West Coast Christian community following allegations of sexual abuse and mismanagement. But the inquiry's findings are not expected to be made public, and there are calls for the government to step in. Ryan Boswell with this exclusive report.
A serve from Gloriavale.
Oh yeah, that's a good backhander.
Kicked out after calling for more accountability after horrific claims of abuse.
There's people that are still at risk there, imminent risk.
Zion Pilgrim, once a leader himself, wrote two letters before he left with his wife and 12 children, hoping it would lead to change.
The response back was, we'll have to wait and see, because we can't rip a page out of the Bible. So essentially what that told me is they will not change anything.
Now a former High Court judge has been called in to investigate. In a statement, Nicholas Davidson QC and Barrister Stephanie Grieve say they've been asked by trustees to look at the issues arising at Gloriavale, and there are no restrictions on that inquiry, meaning nothing is off limits.
The fact that they did agree to have it done shows that this might have been something they could do to strengthen themselves going forwards.
The pressure has been building.
The abuse, it was part of my life, and that was one of the reasons why I didn't want to raise my daughter there.
Former members speaking out, alleging physical, emotional and spiritual abuse.
No annual leave, no rostered days off, nothing.
Last year, proceedings were filed in the High Court calling for Gloriavale's trustees to be removed for poor conduct, mismanagement and dereliction of duty. The civil case is ongoing.
I think part of the problem with Gloriavale is they actually honestly believe that they are right. They have, in the past, been unable to accept that they have behaved inappropriately.
Gloriavale did not respond to requests for comment. There's hope the report finds its way into the hands of government.
We have a duty of care for those people, and I still feel that, and I know, and I tried to do what I could to effect positive change there, and it was blocked, and now I see that I can still help.
The lawyers conducting the inquiry say their findings will go to the trustees for them to respond as they see fit, and that it's confidential to them unless they choose to publish it.
Okay, Ryan joins us now. Ryan, how likely is it that this report will be made public?
Melissa, given that this is considered to be a private matter, lawyers have told me that there is no legal obligation for this to be made public. But remember, there is a Royal Commission of Inquiry into Abuse and Faith-Based Care, which Gloriavale is a part of, and police have an ongoing investigation too in conjunction with Oranga Tamariki, which has already resulted in a number of men being charged with abuse.
And what's the time frame on this inquiry, Ryan?
Well, sources have told me that this inquiry started towards the end of last year, and Gloriavale's leaders are waiting in anticipation for its release in the next few weeks, Melissa.